I'm always.
My wife's not even here.
That's what I like to see. I like to see when I say, "Is anyone loved?" And I like to see men go, like lickety split, right? Because there's always, believe it or not, what just happened, whether you caught this or not, was that a lot of folks here tonight were sitting next, obviously, to their partners. I said, "Is anyone in love?" And they went like this. I've been married for 20 years, little Rev. I don't have to raise my hand. And you know what I say to you? I say, "Yes, you do." Okay? Yes, you do. And, all right, here we go. I'm going to give this a whirl. By the way, I always like to share this with people. If you did meet my wife, you'd see that she's very happy. And the secret to her happiness is this. I wake up every morning, I roll over, I smile before I see her do anything else. I just look at her and I go, "I'm sorry." Every single morning. And you know what I just learned recently, Kent? Milton Berle, the great vaudeville comedian, he said this about marriage. He said, marriage is three rings: engagement ring, wedding ring, and supper ring. Here we go. Enough said. Drop, baby, drop. If you figure out the chorus, you can sing along. Here we go. We'll start off finger picking. Two. Society does not teach young men and women, at least as well as it should. We do many things well, Americans, and I wouldn't want to be anything else. But let's start by teaching our kids, more importantly than just about anything else, how we glamorize love and relationships in every picture on TV and every motion picture. Let's teach our youth to learn how to love themselves first. I mean, really love themselves. When you can love yourself, then it's easy to love somebody else. Otherwise, you wind up with jokes like this one right here. So, Ken,
yeah.
there's this Jewish man, and he goes to temple one day, and he says to his rabbi, he says, "Rabbi, boy, you've got to help me. My wife, she's trying to poison me. I'm telling you," and he's begging and he's pleading with his rabbi to save him. The rabbi's like, "Edith is a sweet woman. What? You're meshugana. She wouldn't try to do something like that." He's like, "Rabbi, please. You've got to talk to her. You've got to do something. She's trying to poison me." So he goes, "I'll go over there and I'll talk to her today." So he goes over there and he says, "I'll wait right here for you to come back. Tell me what she says." So he goes over there, and he's over there about 3 hours or so. They have a very long conversation. Rabbi comes back to the temple. The man's sitting out there on the stoop waiting for him. "So, Rabbi, what happened?" He said, "Well, I went to see your wife. I talked to her for a long time." The man says, "Well, what should I do, Rabbi?" The rabbi looks him in the eye with a straight face and he says, "If I were you, I'd take the poison." "My heart does a tingle, every little move you make. I love you like a mango, you could make it every day. I want you to drop, baby, drop, baby, drop. Drop all your love on me, drop, baby, drop, baby, drop. Because I'm hungry." Just fade it off. Stop, yeah?